Hello, YouTube's Krosama, and here we have today is the high grade after colony Leo. Now, this is a mass produced mobile suit, essentially coming from the Tall Geese being the first mobile suit in this universe, at least to my knowledge, is the first mobile suit. And they basically want to make mass productions of the Tall Geese, but ensuring that the mobile suit in question can be versatile and it will not harm the soldier that is piloting it. So overall, just a grunt suit essentially from the Gundam Wing, and I think it looks fantastic. And I can't ever see a clean Leo. Like Leo's, I think like at the manufacturing factory, it's already damaged. Like it just borderline gets blown up immediately because they're essentially mobile suit fodder for the Gundams. I can't remember if any Leos really did much work that, you know, a normal soldier piloted it. So, I mean, ace pilots that are behind a Leo can do a lot of damage because they still have beam sabers and that can definitely damage the wingsuits. But a normal soldier that doesn't have great experience with piloting it probably isn't going to do too much to a Gundam. But hey, we're talking about the model here. We're not talking about the series. This model, just to kind of give you a little bit of a prelude, this model is fantastic. And it's fantastic in the way that it's cheap. It's not a very expensive model. Yes, there's some limited posability and there's a couple of loose parts. We'll get into that later on in the review. But overall, this is a fairly good kit for a $10 price range. So let's go ahead and just start looking at it from the top to the bottom. Okay, so we're looking at the head essentially has only a couple of colors, which is gonna be the green and then the red. And obviously it's gonna have a clear yellow piece right here. Now it's not gonna have any stickers to put behind that to give it like a reflective look. So all I did is I just painted silver behind that, or if you wanna go ahead and cut out some silver from a sticker sheet, whatever you want to do to kind of make this a little more reflective, you can do that. But I just put a very super metallic silver and it looks pretty good thus far. And there's going to be no posability in the head at all. This is just a fixed, like it comes on a peg, if I could just pull this off. So there's a little peg right there, but it's not going to be able to move because of this little chin piece right there. So that does suck, but hey, it kind of is what it is. Okay, so taking a look at the body, now you can already tell that this is obviously not straight out of the box. I decided to do a lot of weathering to it. So I did like weathering, top coat, and I'll show you right here. So I used basically the Mr. Weathering color. I used a ground brown and I used a multi black. And then I also use, if I can find them, I use some of these little weathering pencils. So they're basically like Mr. Weather liners. So I use a couple of these just to kind of help with the rust effects. And I use a little bit from the Tamiya Weather Master line. So that's actually something that really helps. And I like the overall look of it. I think it looks fantastic. Now obviously it can be better. Trust me, I know I'm not an expert, nor am I like even in the intermediate levels, but I just want to go ahead and do something that's going to, you know, give it a little bit of extra kind of detail. So that's about it. But the body, let's go ahead and take a look at it. It does have a little bend right here, which is really good. So hey, side to side, not bad at all. And then it's just going to be on a single little piece right here, like a little peg, and it can just go back and forth like that. But overall, it looks good. And then this little back piece, this can actually come off. Okay, so this little piece can come off, which tells me that they're definitely gonna release different variants of the Leo. Just, you know, why would you put this here if you was not planning on doing that? So that's just a huge indication that there's gonna be some new variants of the Leo, which it gets me very, very excited because every time a new Leo will come out, I'm going to try and do some different weathering techniques on those Leos. But let's go ahead and move on to the arms. Okay, so for the posability of the arms, basically you can come up that far, and then this little part right here can come out like that. Now this little shoulder piece is just going to be connected on these sides like that. So this can definitely rotate up and down. And obviously there's going to be a swivel right there by the bicep. And there's going to be two points of, actually, no, take that back. There's only one point. Could have sworn there was two, but no. So there's only going to be 1 point, but it's pretty good. So it's probably, what, like 125 degree bend or 130 degree bend, something of the sort. So that's actually not bad. And then obviously the hand is going to be on a little ball joint right there. Now you're only going to get these two type of hands. You're not going to get any open hands or anything like that. But you can easily just get some open hands and replace it if you really want to. If you want to. Okay, so taking a look at the waist, not really much is going on here. I mean, you got these little front skirts right here. They can move up and down, so that's not really anything. I just leave them right there because they don't really interfere with the mobility of the legs or any other part. If I can get this just straightened out. Okay, and you're also going to have side skirts right here, so these can kind of just move around a little bit. Not really going to be able to do any more than really realistically that. Then on the back, these are just fixed, and you're going to have some thrusters right here and a thruster right there, and then obviously there will be a peg right there, and then nothing really too crazy when it comes to the waist, except if I can focus, except for just kind of like this little, you know, kind of wiggle right there. But that's fairly generic with a lot of mobiles, with a lot of high grades nowadays. But overall, you know, it's just a pretty much mostly green, nothing else really crazy going on. Okay, so taking a look at the legs. So the first thing I want to go ahead and mention is that I painted these little peg parts right here. I painted those dark gray, so these are not like molded in or anything. Those are actually supposed to be green, but I went ahead and painted them because I thought it looked a little bit better. So if you can, just go ahead and, you know, paint those if you want. I just think it kind of separates just the straight green that is going to be basically this entire leg, except for the back of the legs right here, which is kind of like a weird, like, tan brownish. Now one thing I do want to mention before I get into articulation is this little piece right here, this little peg, that can actually come out. I'm not going to pull it out because it's kind of hard to, you know, pull out, but there's like just a little hole, so this kind of, you know, makes me think that there's definitely going to be I think it's the space type that utilizes the sides, if I'm not mistaken. But overall, the posability is really good, so you're going to have a really great bend right there, and obviously can do the splits. Can't really go back too far just because the thrusters are going to be right there. And then going forward, it could pretty much just about go all the way. Now there's going to be like a little bend right here where the hip is. And now the ankle skirt, this is something that gives me an issue because look at that. It comes off very easily. And I'm not exaggerating, guys. Like, obviously if I kind of put it on tight, it's going to stay on there for a little bit. But once you start like moving or, once you start like moving it around, it's really just gonna pop off. So be careful with it. You can glue it if you want. I would kind of like maybe recommend not to, just because I don't know. Like I didn't really want to like glue this or anything. I'd rather just keep it kind of how it is. Now when it comes to the ankle articulation, without affecting this, it's gonna go about that far. Now it's gonna be on a ball joint right there, but there's also a little kind of like mobility right here that's inside, and it can go up about that much. And then side to side really is not gonna be impressive. It's okay for what it is, but it's just not impressive. Now if you want, you can actually bring this all the way back like so, but then you can't connect the ankle skirt, so that's just kind of like something that's a trade-off. Or if you want to kind of mod it to where the ankle skirt can go with it, you can do so like that, but overall it's not really going to be able to do that. It looks good though. I really like it. Whoops. I really like it overall. I think it looks fantastic. The color looks great. So let's go ahead and move on to the accessories. Okay, so looking at the first accessory, it's essentially just going to be the rifle. Now, the only articulation you're really going to have on here is going to be this handle. It can kind of just fold out, so that way whenever you're using the other hand to grab it, it can fold out and basically go ahead and stabilize the rifle. But it essentially just slips into the hand like so. And the rifle is essentially a general weapon for the Leos. It's just essentially standard. Now, I know they do have a Doba rifle that they can use as well. It's been a while since I've seen the show, but you know, I do know they have different types of weaponry as far as projectile weaponry, but this is going to be the most standard, and I think it looks fantastic. Great color separation with the gray as well as the black as far as, you know, the main body with the barrel and then the handle and everything. So looks really good, and I just went ahead and painted a little bit extra detail, so like that black for the scope, and then those basically silver kind of panels. I just went ahead and painted that just to give it a little bit of a little bit of extra like accent. All right, and you do get a nice little shield. I kind of just didn't do as good with the rust effects and everything on here. I think I just kind of went a little bit overboard, and I didn't really do too much. I didn't do enough shading to kind of dull out that silver. But, you know, I was like, well, that's whatever. So you do get a shield, and it's going to be two different parts. So all this gray right here is going to be like actual parts for, you know, from the back. Now, this can actually store the beam sabers, which we'll go into after. It has like a little handle right here, but I didn't really... I'm pretty sure it can hold it, but there's nothing that it can actually peg into. So it'd be kind of weird that it would just kind of like flop down, you know, I would imagine. And then this little part is going to be a part for the shoulder, and that's going to be on a little polycap joint right there. So all you need to do is take this off at the top, and then you're going to go ahead and just plug this in the side of the shoulder. So there you have a nice little like shoulder attachment, a little shield attachment on the shoulder, which to me looks really, really nice. And lastly, as far as accessories, you do get two beam saber effects, and then you're gonna get two hilts. One is already underneath the shield, so as you can see, they can store right there, but I just went ahead and pulled one out, and then all you need to do is plug this right into the hand, and then bam, now he can actually wield a nice little beam saber. So if you want your Leo to, you know, wield the beam saber, and there you go. And here's his height comparison with the Rio Grade Tall Geese. So obviously the Wing Series suits, they're just significantly smaller than most mobile suits in the Gundam franchise, usually measuring around like 15 or 16 meters. Okay, so what are my final thoughts and impressions of this kit? Well, for a simple $10, I do feel you are getting your money's worth. And this is a kit that I'm actually kind of tempting to buy a bunch of. Now, it's not for the sake of just having a bunch of Leos in my collection, but I really want to try out a lot of different weathering techniques that I'm trying to learn and really trying to master. Obviously, I can use those techniques on like extra parts that I have in my collection. I have like a whole bunch of extra parts. I have a couple of spare Gundams that just like my Build Strike High Grade, like that's just kind of like very old, and I don't really like it next to like the real grade and the master grade, so I just took it down, put it in a box. So I mean, I can obviously practice on those, but I think the Leos would be such a great kit to just buy for, like, you know, for me at least it's like $8, but you know, for a quick $10, I could practice all I want on the weathering, and I think almost either way it's probably gonna look really good. Now, I tried the sponge technique when it comes to, if you saw like some silver lining, so I tried the sponge technique with some silver paint, which was actually this paint that I got back in the States. I have like four different types of silver, so I was like, let me just try this one. But I went ahead and attempted the sponge technique, and I like it. But I do like the paintbrush technique as well. That's the way I did my chipping on it was another Barbados, the sixth form or something. So ultimately, I do want to try some different weathering techniques, and I think everyone should at least attempt maybe do some weathering on this kit. You know, overall, improve your skills if you can. This is a straight build. You know, all I did was just throw some weathering paint on there. You know, did some stuff with the pastels. And then that was it. So definitely try your hand as well if you can. Just overall increase your skills, guys. My channel has never been about just a straight up, well, okay, I'll take that back. When I first started YouTube, it was kind of like straight out of the box, straight builds. But I had no interest in perfecting my skills. I painted some kits, but I didn't really do too much outside of like my comfort zone. Now, I really want to go ahead and keep up my game. And with this, even though... This came out yesterday for me at this time. But I went ahead and did a whole bunch of work to it in less than a day. So if you just put in the work, man, you can definitely make a straight build like this look decent. You know, it's going to look more presentable on your shelf than just being a basic kit without any panel lining, a top coat, or even if you do, panel lining. Sometimes just throwing a top coat and throwing some little weathering on there, adding some paint, here and there. It's going to make the world a difference. So if you do want to check out a straight up out of the box build, who has it? Kakarot just made one. So I would say watch his. And then once Sako Aurelius makes his, or any of the other YouTubers like Shoki, I would say go watch theirs, the straight clean builds. But me, I'm not gonna be doing that, guys. I think the tall geese is probably the closest thing you're gonna see to like out of box build, because all I did was panel line. I didn't really do anything else, paint or top coat. But that's it for me, guys. I'm tired of rambling on and keeping out here. Thanks for watching. Definitely rate, comment, subscribe. Stay tuned for the post video for the Leo, and as well as the tall geese. That should be happening tomorrow for the tall geese, and then sometime later on in the week for the Leo. But that's it for me, guys. Let me know what y'all think. And also, if y'all wanted me to kind of like give a, I'm not gonna say a tutorial because I'm not a master or an expert, but if y'all want me to do like a let's learn video to where we're like, to where on the video I'm kind of learning, or I'm applying this as much as I can, and we can kind of like do this together, like y'all give me some tips and then I'll try the techniques next time. But if you want me to make some separate videos on like maybe the weathering stuff, or I don't know, maybe even like the panel line stuff, because I think a lot of people are skeptical about using this accent color, and I use this for everything, and I haven't had any issue with my kits thus far. Or maybe even like the markers, if you want to see like how to paint with the markers, which to me is easy. But if you really want to see some stuff like that, let me know in the comments below. But that's it for me, guys. Definitely appreciate all your hard work to type up some comments, but I definitely appreciate y'all, commitment to this channel, and sharing your experiences in the comments, or giving some tips and pointers, or just giving your overall interest to this channel. So thank you, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.